I have an exam trick for breaking down questions about experimental design. But first, a caveat, please take the time to study and understand the main designs. Now, my trick, it's going to help. It's going to help dissect questions, maybe even answer some questions correctly, but it is not enough to make you fluent. But also, it will help a lot. So here goes. Visualize and memorize three defining features of each design. Number one, how many independent variables does the design test? Number two, how many dependent variables does the design measure? And number three, can't hold up all three fingers, what is this design used to do? That's easy enough, right? Oh, and then be sure to include these features on your whiteboard, even during practice tests. Now, reversal or withdrawal designs, one IV, one DV, really great for proving that the IV is responsible for the changes to the DV. Multi-element design, two to four IVs, one DV, great for quickly comparing the effects of several procedures on one behavior. Also, this is the design that we use for functional analysis. Multiple baseline design, one IV, two or more DVs, great for looking at the generalizability of one IV across the different behaviors, different subjects, or different behaviors of one subject, or the different settings in which a behavior might occur. Multiple treatments reversal, one or more IVs, one DV, great for proving and comparing the effectiveness of more than one IV. Changing criterion design, one IV, one DV, great for showing how criteria can control responding. Okay, so now, how do you use this information? Well, first of all, take a moment to write this out, and then take some time to understand and visualize these features. And then, when you have an experimental design question, break down the question by plugging in these little features. How many IVs? How many DVs? And what is the purpose of the experiment in the scenario? Now, I bet more often than not, considering the number of IVs and DVs and the purpose of the experiment will help you get closer to a correct answer. Let me know if that helps. And also, how can I make three fingers? I can't do it.